Welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition on Nightmare Difficulty. We fast travel up to this camp over here since the last time, and we're heading down to seek out and eliminate the Carta leader in the Valimar.
The Carta leader?
Yeah. So he is going to be up over this way near the lake, which we've been to a couple times to do other things. I decided that way was not a good way to go, and I'm doing that because I know I'm correct. It is better to go around and be less silly. Trees get in the way a lot in this game. I never noticed that. I forgot how much the hinterlands trees get in the way. And I like them, but they just get in the way. I suppose it'll stop you from having any chance of noticing how my current leg upgrades clip through my armor, but... you know. Yeah. We'll just pretend that that's not the case. Okay? Okay. Glad we had this chance to win. I don't know what I'm doing half the time. I'm so inconsistent with... this LP, and I hope you enjoy it, because I'm an inconsistent person. So yeah, Valimar's up this way. We got a key from that fortress that's going to let us go in here, whereas we couldn't before, even if we had come up this way. And we can see some Carta people. So I'm going to help deal with them. Dang it, Varric, you just leap being shotted right off that cliff. Bad work, Varric. Bad work. Alright, let's grab this loot. There's an assassin. He was trying to stealth, and he failed. Paralyze him. Bull, you should do something. Thank you, Bull. That was hyper effective.
Lyrium smuggling would be profitable around here.
Iron, got some more iron, lots of iron. And there's that door, and into Valimar we go. Like I said, it is a sort of a location within a location, so to speak. And so we're going to get to go into this smaller area and sort of explore around. It's not too much here. There's like two quests here. This is one of the two quests that like takes you here. But we're going to explore the majority of it this run through. And yeah. It'll be a good time.
Must be an old dwarven outpost. What was it for? Trade, maybe? Your guess is as good as mine.
If Eric doesn't really like the other dwarves. Alright, as a Carta bowman, we're going to bring him. That's how it's rude. There we are. That was what I was supposed to do. So I believe that is not music or a silly sound effect. I believe that is an actual noise that they make upon being actual, like, horn they launch upon being attacked. Well, he's a bowman. He's over there. We're just going to attack him from this far away because I can. Synchronized staffing with me and Vivienne right there. That was rad. Alright. Carta dwarves, if they're anything like the player dwarves and they have the same attributes, which I assume they do, I could be wrong, then they should have magic resistance, which is tough for me, but it shouldn't be a big deal. Actually, I should check that, because... extra melee defense from being a Kunari. Vivienne should have some sort of extra points. I don't think she does. His magic defense does look like it's higher from being a dwarf. Anyway. That way, it's not a way that we should go quite yet. That's a... You'll see why. That's gonna wind up being the way we come out, I guess I'll say. We have some loot that's down here. Mostly look like it's just some resources, but that, and some gold. That's better than nothing, right? Zoom on teleport through the ladder. There should be guys right on top of this ladder for me to zappity zap zap. There are. Daggers. Actually, for rogues, dual wield daggers. Okay, want to make sure I didn't miss anything there. I know that there's going to be a. Oh, nope, that's also. Oh, right, that's what I was thinking of. Boom! Another thing warriors can do. I said we're gonna come here later. I'm going to tell you what it is. If you have a item that can be looted, that generates just random stuff, if you leave at least one thing in it, and come back to it after an area has been reloaded, it will, as it happens, regenerate loot completely. And you can do this over and over again. Thusly, there will be chests that will have a random chance of generating good loot. And the trick is, if they have more than one item in them, to loot the thing that you want, which generally is rare schematics that only have a slight chance of dropping, and then leave anything else. Like, I took a gold, a blue item, and left a gray item. So the gray item will stay there, but not do much. Eventually regenerate, that just will have a chance of getting me treasure again when I come back to this place, because like I said, there's one time I come back to this place, so it's worth leaving those chests like that. I don't usually do that, unless I know I'm probably going to come back to a place. And there are, and there, that can turn into...
We may be too close to the surface for these to count as deep roads, but have I mentioned I hate the deep roads?
So I was going to say, you can't, I'm going to let them fight it out for a little. You can basically farm areas in a way. You can have it so that you're, you know, you save most of the chests in an area so that they will respawn. You get what you can, and you leave and come back and do it over again. Just repeatedly farm certain chests. That's the way to, only way to get certain really rare things that are going to appear randomly. So behind here are the boss people we need to fight, so let's take care of them now. Yeah. but we got him. Oh, that was rude. Come on. You're going down, Skippy. There's a dwarven caught gear, which is going to be used over there, but I need two of them, so... Yep, some more to explore. Maybe that. She's going to heal. Please, without potions in the rest of this area. Not exactly the best thing, and there's some dark spawn out there. So we gotta be careful from here on out. Really smart. Stick this one gear there, we need to go another.
Thank you.
area down here is obviously a door, but won't be useful until another quest later in the game. So that's when that'll take us back here. It's the only other quest in here. Taking out the card out, let's go and head into this vault.
Centuries ago, and yet it remains relatively intact. Dwarven architecture certainly is sturdy.
Leave out broken. Let's reload that autosave that we just used. I could always leave, heal, come back, but I think the enemies respawn in this area for some reason. Oh, that don't.
Must have been abandoned centuries ago, and yet it remains relatively intact. Dwarven architecture certainly is sturdy.
Architecture certainly is sturdy. withdraw into this room. Might need to reload for this withdraw. We reload and then I just have people hold position. First of all, two things. Number one.
This outpost must have been abandoned centuries ago, and yet it remains relatively intact. Dwarven architecture certainly is sturdy.
I have a perk that I never went outside. I didn't do that when I go back. Anyway, I'm gonna save. I gain power just for opening this thing. Thing is, the problem is the real nice stuff is that's inside here. So let's, position for the moment. Position. Okay. Come back another time. I am not dying. So let's leave, and then come back and finish them off and claim my loot from that room. I think enemies will be small, though, is the problem. We'll worry about that when I come back here in the future. That's what I think. That's my plan. So, I think I'm going to finish this off by taking us to Haven, because I have a perk and things to sell. So I'm going to go assign my perk and then sign off, and then probably do some life item management type stuff before I start recording again. Just because, you know. Oh, that's not okay. Well, I forgot that. I'm tired. Ignore that part of the capture. Pretend that it didn't happen. You saw what Chromichrome was like for half a second. Okay. This is the least professional. Well, that's not true. Probably isn't. This is just a, let's say this is a bad let's play. Can we go with that? It's a bad let's play. Anyway. Wow. Totally thought I could do that while it was loading. See, I should be able to. The problem is that, for whatever reason, this week, let's play problems. My recording capture software stopped letting me capture the game directly. It crashes Dragon Age now when I try to do that, but I have to do monitor capture, which I think is more taxing on my processor. Which makes sense, my CPU system is currently telling me that all the processors are, like, third Inquisition perk, I'm going to get the third of the four dialogue perks. I've used the Underworld perk, the Raven shape looking one, multiple times, and I've used the Arcane Knowledge, the swirly blue thing, multiple times. So I think that those have been well chosen. I mean, you know, maybe there would have been times to use history or nobility this early. But I know that history is the one next one that I've seen come up a lot, so I'm going to pick that, and then the one after that will be nobility. And then, And then once I have those four, then it'll be taking actual perks that are cool. Hopefully I'll be able to take the lockpicking perk. That depends on how many. That requires a certain number of perks and secrets, so hopefully I have enough agents and secrets to count as perks for me to be able to take that. But anyway, so I have perks. So let's go take actions, gives me nobility, and then Inquisition gives me history.
My scouts still comb the hills for clues about the explosion. I'll take what I can find.
2, 3. I need 4 points needed before I can take that. Hopefully I'll get another scout. Secrets. Oh, there's the thing I unlocked. Upon the Waking Sea, the Elmari ruins found in the Mount Passages outside Haven have finally given up more of their secrets, pointing to one of the larger islands off the northern coast of Ferelden. The island is quite large and covered in dense wilderness, so searching it will be an involved process. According to the ruins, however, there should be some connection to the original Persephone of Andraste and the Guardian of the Sacred Ashes. This requires stealth if physical agents give enough time to quietly search the islands. As soon as we show interest in the area, those will follow, so let's go in force and occupy the islands. Oh, a few adventurers trustworthy enough to send to the islands. I trust spies.
Let's see what we have.
Gathering quite a bit of power, quite a bit of stuff. So next time, wow, we've gotten most of the hinterlands pretty much cleared out. Next time I think we're probably going to head to the Storm Coast, so we can reach level 9, which is my minimum requirement for going in these next story quests to go deal with the mages. So, till then, have a good life. Good time, everyone. Thanks for watching.